Hi, Lane on Bass here, and today we're going to do something quick and easy because I've been working on videos about 8-9 hours today. I got another 5-6 hours before I get done with this thing, and I just really don't have time to do one of my fancy dinners. So what I did was I got a 2-pack of those pre-made crusts. I got the thin ones, and I call those nacho pizza crusts because they're so thin. And I have some Mexican food left over from last night, so I'm going to make an actual nacho pizza. Y'all follow along. Let's have some fun. Okay, as I said, this is just a basic pre-made crust, very inexpensive. I brushed it with a little bit of olive oil already. Now, you know me and the garlic, right? I'm going to put just a touch on there. Then I'm going to spoon a very little bit of sauce, because I don't ever really like a lot of sauce on my pizza. If I do a lot of sauce, it's because I found a place that does a white pizza, and they either do a garlic cream sauce or an Alfredo sauce. Those I love. They're tons of fun. But tomato sauce, for me, I like it just a little bit going around. I don't like it to be real wet, as they say up in New York and New Jersey. Okay. Obviously, the next thing to do is put some cheese on it. Now it's time for the toppings. And up here, I've got my Ulu knife and this nice bowled out chopping block. And what's really cool about this is that you can run through it and it doesn't run away from you. Isn't that neat? So, time for some chicken. Now this is fajita chicken, but I did it really spicy last night. Very, very hot. That's why I'm not going to put any hot sauce with the tomato sauce underneath the cheese. I'm not going to put any jalapenos because I already had a mountain of those and habaneros and cayenne pepper, and I marinated it for like 4 hours before I sauteed it, so it was pretty spicy already. All right. Next up, some onions. Onions are great for you, high in vitamin C. And it's got to have peppers, so we'll put some hot banana peppers. I don't do anything mild, so these are the ones you get. They tell you they're hot. Uh-oh. Not quite enough peppers in the jar, so we'll spread them out a bit. Okay, it'll look even better when I get just a touch more cheese on there, just a little. Okay, out of the oven after 10 minutes. Looking pretty awesome, right? Let's really dress it up. I'm going to put just a little bit of cheese. Now, normally on a pizza, I would do this with oregano, but since it's a nacho pizza and I don't want that oregano flavor, I'm going to use my backup parsley. By the way, parsley qualifies as a dark leafy green. There it is. That's a nacho pizza, folks. And again, did it with leftovers. Took me very little time. It took me longer to set up for the video than it actually did to prepare the pizza. So, have fun with it. Make it with your own ingredients. I'm laying on base. Y'all keep thumping. Peace.